Blackstone Audio presents Material Witness by Jonathan Maberry. Author's note: this story takes place several weeks after the events in Patient Zero. 1. Echo Team, Case File Report, DMS ET82FD1118. Events of August 16th, prepared August 17th, 11:30 a.m., Team Leader, Captain Joseph Edwin Ledger. Preamble to the official statement of Dr. Rudy Sanchez.
I personally tested Captain Ledger and his men. Blood and urine, a full workup. There is no presence of alcohol or any controlled substance. Standard interview and psychological profiles demonstrate post-traumatic stress and nervous tension typical with recent combat, plus a degree of heightened nervousness that I believe should be ascribed to the unusual nature of the events as described by the members of Echo Team.
From the analysis of a voluntary polygraph test.
All three men were tested separately. I oversaw each test. Each man was given a number of unsequenced control questions as well as the set of questions prepared by Mr. Church. These questions were introduced randomly and without preamble. There is nothing in their responses or on the polygraph tape to suggest that any of them provided false or exaggerated answers. As disturbing and unlikely as it appears, these men believe that they saw and experienced everything exactly as described in Captain Ledger's after-action report and in the private interviews with Dr. Sanchez and Sally and Mr. Church.
Handwritten note included in Mr. Church's private copy of Dr. Sanchez's psychological evaluation of Captain Joseph Edwin Ledger, First Sergeant Bradley Sims, and Staff Sergeant Harvey Rabbit. Note reads,
per your question of earlier today, yes, I am certain that they believe that these events occurred. Please bear in mind the troubled history of that town. It has had far more than its share of troubles for many years. I respectfully but firmly decline your offer to go there and investigate matters for myself. No thank you. R.S.
2. The Warehouse, Department of Military Sciences, Baltimore Field Office, August 16th, 8:19 a.m. One day ago.
God, please, they're killing me here. You got to get me out of this. Jesus Christ, you said this wouldn't happen.
I leaned forward to listen to the voice. Even with the distortion of a bad digital file, I could hear the raw terror, the urgency. When did this come in? I asked. My boss, Mr. Church, sat on the other side of the conference table. He was neatly dressed, the knot of his tie perfect, his face impassive, but I wasn't fooled. This had to be hitting him every bit as hard as it was me.
That's the problem, he said. This message is 3 days old.
3 days? How the hell? Church held up a hand. I paused, dialing it down a notch. How did this get missed? Burke's handler should have called us right away.
The handler didn't get this until this morning.
Then how? This message was left on the home phone of the special agent in charge. He let that float in the air for a moment.
Wait, I said. Home phone? Yes, said Church. And isn't that interesting? Simon Burke would have had no way of knowing who the AIC was, let alone having access to his home number.
Did the handler get a call? Church opened a folder and slid it across the table toward me.
These are the phone records for the handler, Dykstra. The top page is the direct line to Burke's safe house. The next pages are Dykstra's cell and home numbers. The previous call from Burke was the routine check-in last week. Nothing since then. Nothing from a pay phone or from any other line that Burke could have used.
The handler's cell, no, said Church.
There is no identifiable incoming call on any line associated with the AIC or the handler that could have resulted in that message.
I frowned. I don't understand. If Burke left a message, then there has to be a record. Church said nothing. He selected a vanilla wafer from a plate of cookies which sat between us on the table. He nibbled off a piece and munched it thoughtfully, his eyes never leaving my face.
I said, then someone got to the records, altered them.
Difficult, but possible,
He sounded dubious. Or they have a way to erase their tracks, remove all traces of the call. Also possible, but even more difficult, I finished. He said nothing. He didn't have to. There were very few computer systems.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.